गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, मॉर्निंग। वी आर सीइंग द नाइन्थ लेक्चर, वी आर सीइंग द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द नाइन्थ लेक्चर, इम्पैक्ट ऑफ जेट ऑन मूविंग कर्व प्लेट व्हेन द जेट स्ट्राइक्स टेंजेंशियली एट वन टिप एंड लीव्स एट द अदर। नाउ दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट। इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी सॉ द डायग्राम, ओके, वी सॉ ऑल द एब्रीविएशंस एंड वी सॉ द इनलेट वेलोसिटी ट्रायंगल एंड द outlet velocity triangle. Okay, in the second part we saw how to draw inlet velocity triangle and outlet velocity triangle. Okay, now in this third part of the ninth lecture we are going to derive the equation of impact of jet on, or we are going to derive the equation of force exerted by the jet on a moving curved plate when the jet strikes tangentially at one tip and leaves at the other. Okay, now if the vane is smooth, okay, vane means we know moving curved plate, okay, if we see vane it means moving curved plate, okay, if vane is smooth and having velocity in the direction of motion at inlet and outlet equal, then that means if the vane is smooth and if the velocity in the direction of motion and at inlet and outlet is the same for a plate or a vane, then u1 is equal to u2. That means now u1 is the velocity of the plate at the inlet tip, okay, velocity of the plate, remember this, and u2 is the velocity of plate at the outlet tip. Okay, now both u1 and u2 are the velocity of the plate, this which plate, this curved moving plate. Okay, now this moving plate is a solid, okay, so velocity at any point on this plate, on this solid plate, it will be same. Okay, if we see at this tip the velocity will be same, if we see at the center of the plate the velocity is same, if we see at this tip the velocity will be same. Why? Because this plate is a solid homogeneous substance, okay, homogeneous material. So u1 and u2, these are the velocities of the plate at inlet and outlet, they will be equal to u, which will be the velocity of plate in the direction of jet, and vr1 is equal to vr2. Now we have seen here, if the vane surface is assumed smooth, okay, the energy loss due to friction will be zero, and thus vr1 will be equal to vr2. Okay, so by that relation vr1 is equal to vr2. Now mass of water striking the plate per second, okay, it will be rho a into vr1, where vr1 is the relative velocity with which the jet strikes the plate, okay, where a is area of jet. Now next we'll find out the force exerted in the direction of motion. Okay, what is the force exerted in the direction of motion? First, what is the direction of motion? It is the x direction. So force exerted in the direction of motion is fx. It is mass of water striking the vane per second multiplied by initial velocity with which the jet strikes in the direction of motion minus final velocity. Now mass of water striking the vane per second, we have seen it here, mass of water striking the vane per second, it is rho a into vr1. Okay, so we know this value. Now initial velocity with which the jet strikes in the direction of motion, okay, now first what is the velocity with which the jet strikes, okay, what is the velocity with which the jet strikes? It is vr1. Okay, why? Because the jet strikes the plate with a relative velocity vr1. Okay, go back in the first part and you will see why. Okay, so the jet strikes the plate with a relative velocity vr1. Okay, so initial velocity with which the jet strikes in the direction of motion, so we have to find out the vr1 velocity and its component in the direction of motion. So what is the component of VR1 in the direction of motion? It has two components. Okay, in the direction of motion it is CD, and in the direction of in the direction perpendicular to the motion it is BD. Okay, so we have to consider the component of VR1 in the direction of motion, that is CD. So what is CD? It is VR1 into cos theta, because cos theta is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse. Okay, what is adjacent? CD upon hypotenuse CB, and hypotenuse is VR1. So VR, we'll see, initial velocity with which the jet strikes in the direction of motion, it is VR1 cos theta. Okay, so this CD, okay, CD is VR1 into cos theta. Okay, now final velocity in the direction of motion. Okay, now final velocity is when the jet leaves the plate at the outlet. Okay, so VR2. Now it's the component of VR2 in the direction of motion, that is in the x direction, it is C dash D dash. It is VR2, so what is the component? It is C dash D dash, that is VR2 into cos phi. VR2 into cos phi. Okay, but as it is opposite to the direction of motion, it is minus sign. Okay, so final velocity, initial velocity VR1 cos theta minus final velocity, it is minus VR2 cos phi. Okay, now but from the figure we will see that VR1 cos theta is equal to VW1 minus U1. Okay, if we see from this figure, okay, CD is VR1 cos theta. Now CD, what is the value of CD? It is VW1 minus U1. This CD is VW1 minus U1. So it is given here, VW1 minus U1. Next, VR2 cos phi is equal to U2 plus VW2. Now if we see at the outlet, okay, this C dash D dash is VR2 into cos phi. Now C dash D dash is U2 plus VW2. Okay, so it is U2 plus VW2. Thus, this effect will be equal to rho A into VR1 into what is VR1 cos phi? It is VW1 minus U1 minus into bracket minus what is VR2 cos phi? It is U2 plus VW2. Okay, solving further, fx is equal to rho A into VR1 into bracket VW1 minus U1. This minus minus, it becomes plus U2 plus VW2. Now, but we have seen in the last slide, U1 is equal to, I'll show you, U1 is equal to U2 is equal to U. Okay, so this U1 and U2, they are nothing but equal to U. So this will be minus U plus U, and these both will get U11 and U1 and U12, U2 will get cancelled. So fx is equal to rho A VR1 into VW1 plus VW2. This is equation number 1. Okay, next. Now equation 1 is true only when beta is an acute angle. Okay, now if we see the diagram again. Okay, so what does it say? Equation 1 is true only when beta is an acute angle. Now this beta, it is an acute angle. So the equation number 1 that we saw, it is true only when beta is an acute angle. Now what happens if beta is 90 degree? That means this, if beta is 90 degree, it means V2 will come over here. Okay, and if V2 comes over there, then VW2 will be equal to 0. Then the equation, first equation number 1 will become fx is equal to rho A VR1 into VW1, because VW2 is 0. Now if beta is an obtuse angle, that is if it is greater than 90 degree, then equation 1 will become rho A VR1 VW1 minus VW2. So thus in general, Fx or force in x direction in the direction of motion of vane is written as Fx is equal to rho A VR1 into bracket VW1 plus minus VW2. Okay. So this is the formula for force in the direction of motion exerted by the jet on a plate when it strikes tangentially. Okay. Next, we'll see the work done. Okay. Now work done formula, we have seen all these points. Finally, we know the work done per second is force in the x direction into velocity of plate. Now force in x direction is rho A VR1 VW1 plus minus 1 VW2 into velocity of plate. What is the velocity of plate? It is u. Okay. So here we have finished the part of impact of jet on moving curved plate when the jet strikes tangentially at one tip and leaves at the other. Thank you.